I want to thank all of you for being here today, and I know the hour is getting late and you've got better things to do, but it's really important because this is the first time the House has really heard from the governors. So I want to ask you a broader question because we all need to know this. I know from my governor, I love you, Jared, but I talk to my governor a lot because that's what I'm there to do, are in desperate need for more relief. I know she's working with our I want to hear from both of you, but she's working with our state legislature on critical budget needs now. Can you talk about the urgent need for more funding for the states, the counties, and the cities to make up for lost revenue? And what would happen if Congress doesn't provide you with more direct relief to the states, to the counties and the cities? And I guess, Jared, forgive me, I'm gonna go to my governor first. But you're handsome.
Oh, he is. All right, we can agree on that. That's unanimous, okay. So I do appreciate the question. I think that it's really important. You know, COVID-19 has wreaked havoc on our state budgets, and we have about a $6.2 billion total loss in the current fiscal year and next. It's a crisis unlike anything we've seen before, and it is all associated with the public health crisis. Every governor, regardless of affiliation, we're working with the NGA to make sure that you and Congress understand the plight that we are all confronting. The numbers show that we need flexibility. We need additional support from the feds if we're going to continue saving lives and re-engage our economy and provide critical services to the people of our states. We can't do this alone. We need federal government partnership here. And I think the bottom line is we really need additional flexibility and additional resources. We, none of us would want the people that stayed on the front line and put themselves in harm's way to take care of everyone else to bear the brunt of these budget shortfalls. And when the biggest parts of our budgets are consumed by public health, public safety, and public education, those are those frontline heroes that we want to support, not undermine. And obviously, the health of our economies depends on us being able to balance these budgets so we can continue to make the right decisions for the right reasons in our states all across the country.
Thank you, Governor. Governor Polis.
Yeah, we were certainly grateful for the help in the CARES Act. I honestly don't know where we would be to address these enormous response costs that our local agencies have had without the CARES Act money. We also would be extremely appreciative of the help that's in the HEROES Act in some form reaching the president's desks, because I can tell you it's very challenging for states. Unlike the federal government, we have a balanced budget requirement. States are not able to borrow. We would have enormous cutbacks at a time when many Colorado families could afford it the least. The necessary social services, our social safety net, Medicaid expansion would be in jeopardy if not for FMAP and increased assistance. So it's really a critical time for the federal government to step up, protect the most vulnerable, and protect our future by supporting our schools.
So thank you for that answer. I have one, we don't have that much time, but I'm very worried about a return, seeing spikes again. I'm out and people aren't wearing masks. They're not keeping physical distance. They're not listening to what you all are saying and the doctors are saying. I'm very worried about the lack of PPE equipment. We've got several weeks supply right now, but if we have another spike, I'm worried what will happen in the country again. And I could go through another list. What do you both think Congress needs to be doing right now to help prepare for the fall? I'll go to you first, Governor Polis, since I
Also, and we're not even through the first wave. There's areas of the country, and certainly in Colorado, areas of our state that have an increase, have outbreaks that for a couple of weeks have been going up. Most of our state has been going down, but there are, you know, several areas across our state that have been going up and across the country. So the first wave isn't over. It's still, while the overall trends are getting better, it's still on the uptick in a number of places. Mask wearing is absolutely critical, and modeling mask wearing at all levels of civil society, including people that have a soapbox like yourselves, those who serve in Congress. I certainly model mask wearing also because, by the way, I want to protect myself and my family. But I also want to model it for the general public. And of course, building social distancing into how we do work. I applaud United States Congress for doing that and not putting yourselves and your staffs at risk by having to do things the old-fashioned way, the normal way, and bring everybody together in a room. We're able to have this conversation in just as effective a way while being safe. Our state legislature has taken similar efforts as well.
Governor.
Just say ditto. I know we're out of time, but I think Jared, Governor Polis articulated very well what it is that we need to not let our guard down. We have to learn to live with COVID-19 and change our culture around how we personally conduct ourselves. And it starts with mask wearing, and it continues with social distancing. And the consistent, medically accurate information needs to come from everyone with a platform.
Thank you.
Thank you.